Okay, this is Dr. Jawan. I'm just continuing a series from a viewer that emailed me, and she was asking about, please explain the differences in estrogen you have, because she's read about you have the good, you have the bad, you have the ugly. She wants to clean up her liver pathway because she thinks she has PCOS. She already has insulin resistance. She has hair growth, okay, in her chin, unwanted. And she just really wants to get her life back in order, and she's kind of curious on what is the story behind different estrogens. Now, in a previous video, I kind of broke down just the three different types of estrogens. And remember, so it is, estrogen is needed. It's made from cholesterol. All hormones are made from cholesterol, so we need cholesterol for overall body function. In addition, it's broken down through the aerobic metabolism involving oxygen. In addition, it helps balance out the good and bad cholesterol, and for females, it helps balance out the mood, the serotonin, the dopamine, gut motility, brain function, libido. So a good balance of estrogen is needed. Now, you have the good, the bad, the ugly, and even in males too, you could throw off the good, the bad, the ugly estrogens with diet, a poor liver pathway, and so forth and so on. So when it comes to estrogen metabolism, I'm going to talk about two phases. Now, everything is passed through the liver. The liver is a phenomenal organ. I always say it acts as a filter. It has over 300 functions. It turns on inactive vitamins to active vitamins. It helps establish the hormonal pathway, and it really is really important to focus on liver health. That is always my goal, is to clean up the liver. Also to the diet: gluten, wheat, dairy, soy, peanuts, processed foods, diet sodas, pulverized medications pulverize your liver. So again, let's get back up to clean up the liver with supplementation, amino acids, L-cysteine, N-acetylcysteine, glutathione, milk thistle, omega-3 fatty acids. Anything that's going to help clear up the liver pathway is going to help establish, in this particular case, the estrogen metabolism. Now, it all starts off with testosterone. Then what happens is that it goes through the liver pathway, and it splits onto, I would say you have this big walking thing of estrogen, then it splits into three different types of estrogen. Estrone, E1. Estradiol, E2, estriol, E3. Now, in the phase one liver pathway, you're involving cytochrome P450 enzymes, in particular, A1A liver enzyme, which focuses on the breakdown of estriol. Now, you have the good, the bad, the ugly. So what happens through phase one, it breaks it down to 2-hydroxyestrone. This is the good estrogen. You want this. It's very weak, but also too, it's very harmless. So then you have the 4-hydroxyestrone, this is bad. And then you have the split down of 16-hydroxyestrone, this is the ugly. Now, you could throw off the balance of the estrogens through liver, through your diet, through stress, through medication. Now we have phase two. The phase one is just basically splitting them into metabolites. Phase two, the function of phase two is to turn the estrogens, basically turn them on, into water-soluble compounds which can be utilized, that can be excreted in the gut and also in the urine. Basically, you're turning them on. And that's called conjugation. Now phase two involves conjugation, it involves methylation, sulfation, and glucuronidation. Those three processes are involved in phase two. You could have an imbalance. Your main goal is always to have the good estrogen. Why the good estrogen? Because it's the best. It's a weak metabolite that has a lower rate for cancer. Because remember, the function of estrogen, one of the functions of estrogen is cell replication. Think about the female hormonal cycle. You have 5 days of your menses. Then you have days 6 through 14. What's happening? Estrogen's being utilized to lay down the uterine lining, replicate the cells. You have day 14, ovulation. You have the surge of luteinizing hormone, which creates the ovulation, which gets the egg out of the ovary. Now the egg is making its way down the fallopian tube, and it switches over to progesterone, progestation. That's the maturation of the cells. So estrogen could be good and bad, depending on what type of estrogen you're talking about. So then here you have 4-hydroxyestrone, which again, phase two is going to turn into the metabolites. This is bad. This could cause DNA damage, increase oxidation, increase inflammation. This is the type of estrogen that causes PMS, cramps, menstrual dysregulation, headaches, mood disorders. Now, this is 4 times more active in breast cancer cells. What's the function of estrogen? Cell replication. You want good and you want bad. You want to eliminate the bad. Now, this is the ugly. This is the really ugly kind, because what happens is that now it could go either way. It could bleed back up into estriol, E3. Now, E3, this is the type of estrogen that is mainly utilized with the pregnancy. This is why, again, estrogen could be your best friend or your worst enemy. You want this estrogen when you're pregnant. Why? Because you're replicating a human being. You don't want this estrogen when you're not replicating a human being, but the body doesn't know. See, it just converts 16 hydroxyestrone teeth to estradiol. Now you're replicating the cells. What cells are those replicating? The bad cells. Because why? Potential tumor initiators, promotes unscheduled DNA growth and synthesis, plays a role in breast cancer induction. So what I'm trying to convey is the fact that estrogen is good and estrogen is bad. But now, what are we going to do to help correct that pathway so you're producing less of the 4 and the 16, and you want to produce more of the 2? Okay, so thanks for watching. If you have any comments, please leave them down below. Thank you.